A Regretful Party with the CEO. Chapter 2: Running into Heaven's Seat. 5 years later, at YCTS Airport, Nicola's face was completely covered behind a pair of shades and a face mask. In fact, she was so wrapped up that she resembled a mummy. She wondered whether the man who wanted to give it back to her a hundredfold had continued searching high and low for her over the past 5 years. If it weren't to save a certain someone, she would never risk coming back. She dragged her suitcase forward with a pounding heart, and her pace quickened the more she walked. Meanwhile, the three little ones behind her tagged along as they tried to match her pace with their stubby legs. Suddenly, a high-pitched voice sounded loud and clear behind her. "Mommy, you're walking too fast. I am getting hungry just trying to keep up. I feel like eating chocolate, cupcakes, French toast, and..." SHHH. Nicole looked back and put a finger to her lips, afraid that they might attract too much attention, unwanted attention. The voice belonged to a girl named Maya. She was Nicola's youngest child and a glutton through and through. "Behave, Maya. Mommy will bring you to get some dessert later, okay?" Maya's eyes lit up, and she nodded enthusiastically. Standing beside her was Nana, who was a carbon copy of Maya. She shook her head in an adult-like manner and heaved a deep sigh. "If you keep eating this much, you'll become a fat pig. We should take care of our body, Maya." Maya turned to glance unhappily at Nana. "Don't say it like you don't eat. That's called tasting. I only have one bite. One bite still counts." "No, it doesn't." "Yes, it does." "No, it doesn't. Tell her, Juan." Nana couldn't take it anymore and seek for her brother's help. Abruptly being put in a tough spot, Juan scratched his head, unsure of what to do. Since Nana and Maya were both his sisters, so he didn't know who he should help. "I think you're both right." Hearing his reply, both Nana and Maya rolled their eyes at Juan and harumphed loudly before storming ahead. "All right, that's enough now. Kids, come on." Nicole gently rubbed Juan's head, to which he nodded and trailed after her. Among the three, Maya was the smallest in size, fuming and stomping forward without looking where she was going. She accidentally bumped against a woman's leg and fell back onto the floor. "What the hell? Are you blind?" Maya looked up at the woman who looked like she wanted to bite her head off. "This lady is so fierce. Maya, are you okay?" Seeing her sister being knocked down, Nana rushed forward and helped Maya up. Then, she gave the woman a once-over. Although the woman was very beautiful, she couldn't hold a candle to their mother. Besides, Nana didn't like how rude she was, and it was clearly written all over her face. "Why are you looking at me like that? Apologize," the woman yelled at Nana. "I am sorry, Mayam," Maya said in her cute voice and looked at the woman with large eyes that gleamed with sincerity. Nana, on the other hand, gave her little sister a flat stare. "What is Maya doing? Why did she apologize?" "You too, apologize to me," the woman ordered Nana in a superior tone. However, Nana stared unflinchingly at her and stood there without saying a word. "What's going on? What's wrong?" A man and a woman's voice sounded in unison. One of the voices belonged to Nicole, while the other voice sounded rather familiar to Nicole. So she instinctively looked up, and her heart almost stopped. She hastily bowed her head, cursing vehemently in her heart. "It's that man from 5 years ago. Freakin' Heaven's Seat. What a pathetically small world. I can't believe I ran into him the second I step foot in this country." Welcome to download Flipread APP to read more chapters of A Regretful Party with the CEO novel online.